Hi all. Imagine a situation when you come home and the refrigerator does not work. The light inside is on, but it doesn't freeze. In addition, the air conditioner broke down, or another situation when the computer and plasma TV no longer work. They were in standby mode and suddenly stopped turning on. Why did this happen? An accident occurred on the line outside the apartment, for example, the neutral wire burned out. And the voltage began to differ from the standard. Burning out the neutral wire is called a zero wire break in electrician jargon. We'll talk about zero loss and its consequences in one of the following videos. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss it. And of course, I will be grateful for your likes and reposts. They inspire me to make new videos. In the first case, the voltage turned out to be significantly less than standard, and the compressor in the refrigerator and the motor in the air conditioner were unable to spin up. As a result, due to the inrush current, they burned out. In the second case, an overvoltage occurred. The power supplies of the computer and TV are always energized in standby mode. Due to overvoltage, they burned out. If the computer or TV was turned on when the voltage increased, the consequences will be even worse than a burned-out power supply. The refrigerator and air conditioner can also burn out due to overvoltage. How to insure against this? One of the surge protection devices is a voltage monitoring relay. In everyday life, it is more often called a voltage relay. Electrical engineer Igor Ekimov is with you. In this video, we will look at this voltage relay. What is it for and how to use it? Most household electrical appliances are designed to operate at a certain mains voltage. Operating these devices when the mains voltage is outside the permissible limits can lead to their failure. The main purpose of a voltage relay, RN, is to disconnect consumers from the network when the voltage goes beyond these values. After the voltage is turned off, the relay continues to control the line. When the voltage is restored, after a certain time the relay will turn on the load again. In addition to protection against low and high voltage, it has the following additional functions. 1. Adjustment of the upper voltage threshold. 2. Adjustment of the lower voltage threshold. 3. Protection against overcurrent. 4. Adjustment of the current response level. 5. Adjustment of the relay response time. 6. Adjustment of voltage restoration time. 7. Measuring and displaying the voltage level in the network. 8. Measuring and displaying the current consumed by the load. This voltage relay is especially distinguished by current protection. You can set the exact current value at which the relay will operate. This allows the machine not to operate in emergency modes. If the rated current of the input circuit breaker is say 25 amperes, and we will install current protection on the relay at 25 amperes, then the machine will not overheat. When the current exceeds 25 amperes, the voltage relay will turn off the load. That is, the voltage relay will work as current protection, and the machine will protect against short circuit current. The voltage relay and the circuit breaker must work in pairs. Since the voltage relay itself does not have short circuit current protection, the relay has the following indicators. 1. Maximum operation voltage. 2. Minimum voltage trigger. 3. Current trigger. 4. Relay output status. If the indicator is green, then the load is on. If the indicator is red, it is turned off. To program the voltage relay, there are three buttons: set, up and down. Using the set button, we switch the values that we want to change, and using the up and down buttons, we set this value. Holding the button for a long time turns on the accelerated mode of changing the value. How to program the relay can be found in the instructions for the voltage relay. True, the instructions are in English. Google Translator will help you. The relay is already set to default relay trip values. For example, the upper threshold is 270 volts, and the lower threshold is 170 volts. I do not agree with these values, as well as with the standard relay response time. I will record and post another video on the channel, where I will show what relay settings I made for myself. I will post the link in the description. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss this video. The voltage relay consumes power up to 2W and allows protection to operate up to 100,000 times. Mounts on 35mm DIN rail. This relay allows you to connect wires up to 25mm too. Wires of larger cross-section are practically not used in household electrics. This voltage relay is 40A and 63A. I posted a link to this relay in the description. But it is worth noting that this voltage relay will not protect against impulse noise, resulting from a lightning strike. Here you need a faster response to shut down than a voltage relay can do. For this purpose, impulse noise protection devices are used. In short, they are called SPDs. I'm also going to make a video on them in the future. Some appliances, such as gas boilers, require constant mains voltage. For this purpose, there are voltage stabilizers that can compensate for relatively slow voltage changes. Stabilizers should be used in conjunction with a voltage relay. They operate over a relatively narrow voltage range. When the voltage changes in this range, the stabilizer maintains the voltage around the nominal 230 volts. When the stabilization limits are exceeded, the voltage relay switches off the load. The relay is placed in front of the voltage stabilizer, so that it protects the stabilizer from failure. In the next video, using a real example, I will show how to install a voltage relay in a panel. At the same time, I'll show you how to program this relay and what relay settings are optimal. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss this video. As always, I will be grateful for your likes, reposts, and comments. See you in new and old videos. Bye.